Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Wednesday, June 7th. It is going to be another hazy and hot day today in the Garden State. Temperatures are going to be into the 70s, near 80 today. But the big concern again is going to be the smoke. There is a very high danger of smoke contamination in the air again today, and that is from a number of factors. First, there is another wildfire in New Jersey. This one is burning in Jackson, Ocean County, threatening dozens of homes and businesses. More than 50 acres have burned so far. Crews are struggling to get containment. This is just south of Route 195 in the area of East Commodore Boulevard and Cedar Swamp Road. We are expecting an update from the Forest Fire Service later this morning. Meanwhile, smoke was bad yesterday. We're getting a bit of a break this morning. That's the smoke pouring in from those Canadian wildfires. We'll get a bit of relief, but it's going to get bad again later in the day. If you have breathing issues, doctors say stay inside. And those masks that we were wearing for COVID, they won't help. Even the N95 isn't enough to filter out the smoke. We have full coverage this morning on air, online at NJ1015.com, and on our free mobile app. Did you get your anchor property tax rebate check? The vast majority of you have, but tens of thousands are still waiting. The Treasury Department says more than 1.5 million anchor checks have already been mailed out to homeowners and renters. But of those 30,000 applications that are still pending, most have missing or conflicting information, and the state is working to be able to resolve that before they can formally issue those checks. So what do you do if you haven't received your check yet? Check out our updated Asked and Answered column this morning at NJ1015.com. An Ocean County youth wrestling coach is accused of sharing child pornography. Alec Donovan of Brick, who was also a referee for the sport, pleading guilty in Trenton Federal Court to one count of distribution of child pornography. When sentenced in the fall, the 26-year-old faces between 5 and 20 years in prison, as well as a $250,000 fine. Marine strandings continue off the Jersey shore. Two bottlenose dolphins and a porpoise found in the last week at Seaside Park, Middle Township, and Long Beach Township. The Marine Mammal Stranding Center confirming the findings, but not the cause of death. A freak accident has claimed the life of a woman on the Garden State Parkway. 46-year-old Elena Clark was driving her SUV on the parkway in Toms River when she hit a wheel that had fallen off of a pickup truck. That truck had been involved in a separate accident ahead of her. Clark's SUV veered to the left and then hit that pickup. The Lakehurst woman was dead at the scene. Politics this morning, primary day yesterday. Results this morning, Ed the Trucker fending off a stiff challenge from South Jersey's 3rd District, fellow Republican Assemblywoman Beth Sawyer. This race got particularly nasty in recent weeks, but Durr beat back the challenge. He will now face former Assemblyman John Berzicelli in November. Senator Dick Cody easily won his primary against fellow Senator Nia Gill. The two were vying for a single seat created by redistricting. They are among the longest-serving lawmakers in Trenton and the first incumbent versus incumbent Senate primary in New Jersey's history. National politics, it is official. Chris Christie is going to run for president again, making the formal announcement last night during a town hall event in New Hampshire. He has promised to directly confront Donald Trump, something the other candidates have refused to do. Christie joins an increasingly crowded GOP field that includes Trump, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, South Carolina Senator Tim Scott, and former UN Ambassador Nikki Haley. You remember that Jersey guy who was driving his Tesla in Woodbridge when the steering wheel just popped off? That was back in January. Tesla has now issued a recall. Some 2022 and 2023 Tesla models are affected by what the company says is a faulty steering wheel fastener. Tesla only made the recall under pressure from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Wednesday, June 7th. Have a great day.